Good afternoon again. My name is Humberto Cabrera, Senior Associate at the ICTP, Professor and Director of the Winter College on Optics, Advanced Optical Techniques for Bioimaging. And now I want to say some specific point of this Winter College. This is very particular Winter College because we will have in the morning lectures and in the afternoon experimental session to combine theory and practice. And for that objective, we have designed a series of experimental sessions, and I am going to show now the second experiment. This experiment is based on an optical technique known as a thermal lens spectroscopy and thermal lens microscopy. The idea of this technique, or the application of this technique, is to extract the information. For example, of this sample, that is, in this case, pure ethanol or pure water, or a semiconductor materials in which we excite, we put the sample here before this mirror, and we excite periodically with this green laser. Then we produce an optical element called thermal lens, temporary thermal lens, there, which is tested by a second beam called probe laser. This laser passes through the sample one time, twice, is reflected here, and then detected there at the detector plane. And we have this kind of signal, of course, because if we have a temporary lens, the beam converges and diverges. But this is proportional to the absorption of the sample and also to the thermal properties. These are the parameters we are interested in. Due to that, when we extract this signal and process, we can, for example, build a calibration curve, for example, or samples, river waters, bottled water, or natural waters, and we can measure there, for example, the concentration of heavy metals. We can say chrome 3, chrome 6, iron 3, in very, very low level. The specific novelty of this kind of experiment is that we add a resonator to the conventional thermal lens spectroscopy or microscopy. We add one mirror here that gives the possibility, this beam, to come back and to pass twice through the sample. But if we add a second mirror that is here, we create a resonator in which the probe beam will be passing multiple times through the sample. And this, of course, increase the path length and increase the sensitivity of the method. For example, with this method, we were able to measure 21 nanogram per liter, this is PBT levels, per trillions, in chrome 3, chrome 6 in drinking waters. We also were able to measure iron 2 in waters, in natural waters, at the level of 8 nanogram per liter, 8 PPT. I want to say also that this setup can be used when we have a microscope objective instead of a lens. We can concentrate the excitation beam in a very, very small area, and we can increase the sensitivity of the method. For example, for some semiconductor materials or for some 2D materials as graphene, we can do a map of the surface of this very thin sample, and we can extract very, 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 very useful information with very, very high resolution. And with this setup, students coming to the next Winter College of Optics will be working and doing measurement during afternoon, even using their own samples. Thank you very much for your attention.